Oh, actually, you one minute, I'm sorry. Okay, good. Okay, we have four people in. Okay, I suggest that everybody enter the demonstration because we are going to start. I will just wait for one extra minute so to get everybody in. Just 1 minute. Yeah, at my time, if it's 11:01, we start. So now 40 seconds to go. Hey, Niels. Yes, hi, okay. I didn't know you belong to this group too. How are you doing? Aha, in Berlin, huh? Yes, I have a student there played in Berlin Chronic, so I know. But okay, anyway, sorry. Niels, I will talk to you later, but for now, let's enter the lecture, all right? So I guess everyone is ready. I have everyone's attention. Hi. All right, okay, so now let's enter the lecture. How can you mute KDS? I'm sorry. Okay, can I start? If I can start, I'm gonna start. Okay, so today our topic is about to feel the flow and do the attacking. All right, so about this topic, basically it is about your design and planning. Yeah, this is basically what we need to do in attacking. As you all know, attack is actually a difficult topic in Go. And, about this, many people has no idea what exactly you should do. And so from the following examples, basically, thanks to Inazuma and Fuz, you have supplied many examples, and I have chosen most of them here in order to mainly answer your questions and also to explain this this topic. And also I have selected some examples from my students' game, and one last is a pro game, okay? Yeah, okay, now let's start. And we start from this example. So this is a given situation, and this is the example from Inazuma. All right, so black last move, he has just shouldered here. And the question is how we should attack it, or actually, okay, I will make it more accurate. Here, the question is supposed to be, what white should do in order to deal with this shoulder? And okay, so here I'm not gonna give any tip yet. What do you think? And I hope everyone will be able to actively join the discussion. And so you may actually compare, let's say, the ideas. And finally, when I tell you what you should do, you may actually check out about how you think. And I mean, as a comparison, with my opinion. Okay, anyone, please speak. 16 mostly. All right, okay. Now I can see three people answered in our room. We have like 10. I'd like to hear a few more before I introduce the method. Okay, 14. All right. Okay. Okay, so we have like half of the people in this room has given opinion. Okay, so many of you, when I ask this question, you actually almost every one of you you replied to me about what you're gonna do as your next move. Well, that's not bad, but that is what I call a reaction goal. Let's say when we play Go, we don't do reactions. He played this move, what we should do as a move. Okay, what I suggest every one of you, I believe you are probably just like me now. You are sitting in front of a computer and probably leaning towards the computer relatively closely. Now I want everyone to lean your back, okay, towards your chair. Just sit comfortably and look at this whole board. Okay? I want to confirm you're all doing that. I'm doing that. Are you? So away from the board. Yeah, relax and back. Yes. Okay, that's pretty good. And now I don't want you to tell me about your move. Basically, we say when black shoulder here, because this is a shoulder towards a lower stone, so white is not supposed to locally answer to that or react to that. So we normally, okay, I answered one of the questions earlier. We normally do not consider Tanuki idea like E10, because then you let black to play two moves in a row locally, it hurts. So basically, one has two directions to choose, right? I want you to actually just look into those two directions and the following moves. I want you to just look at a variation you may have in your mind. Just both sides play simple moves. Just both sides play simple moves, all right? For example, I just push up and he nobody here. I came up, he jumped, I jumped, he jumped. You know, only simple moves. And tell me the picture you can see on both. Yeah, on both answers. I'm sorry, D11. Ah, okay. Okay, I want to see a few more. Okay, Ina Zuma here is actually telling us something about her impression. Okay, actually, basically the impression she has told us, this is what I want you to get. Because now, yeah, you are showing me, okay, the variation will be blah, blah, blah. What is your impression? What do you think about, yeah, this attacking, how it is going? Do you like it for white or black? And so let's say, is this black group easy to attack as your impression? For example, is that easy to attack as you're feeling? Yeah, after you tell yourself that picture. Not easy, okay? I guess yeah, that's also the opinion from Ina Zuma. All right. Okay, so this is the flow. Okay, remember our topic? The flow. Feel the flow in attacking. Just feel the flow. Here, you already feel the flow. You already know that, okay, as a general picture, no matter how I answer, this group is not easy to attack. You already know this. Then what you should do? Perfect. Yes, that is the answer. It's not easy to attack, then don't attack it. So here, yeah, what white should do is you just leave it there, but you can't completely leave it there. What you need to do is to make sure black cannot easily get settled, or he cannot easily get leaving. You keep it weak. And then I don't know how to attack, so I leave it. So for example, I just show an example. But I put here, black Novi, Kama, and the black two space jump, leave it now. Because it's not easy to attack, right? So just leave it. And like this, because black is not alive himself. So he will need to add a move himself eventually, even if you're Tanuki. But you know, here we say this black group is not easy to attack. If you just keep attacking, you say, he has a VP group. I don't know how should I attack, or I don't know where is the benefit. I keep attacking. It is easy to come to a result. Finally, black group is alive. You get nothing out of it. Then why not just leave it there and keep him weak to wait for a changing of circumstances? And eventually, black is the one, if he realizes he's weak, he will need to add a move anyway, which is locally small, and you're gonna get a big move elsewhere. I guess this is clear. In general, yes, but okay, it's more like this. Because here, this group is difficult to attack. You keep attacking it, it's easy to come. You attack this group to live. If this group is alive, there's nothing you can get, nothing further you can get after, right? Yeah, so in that case, you'd rather just leave it there and let's see how the circumstances change. And Inazuma here is asking a question, how do we plan to make those circumstances that will allow us to attack easier? Okay, this is a good question, but this is a difficult question, I have to say, because even to pro, this is a difficult one. But I can tell you the answer here. The answer is supposed to be, you still, in general, play the biggest move on the board. There's nothing else you can do, but you just play the biggest move elsewhere on the board. But if it happens to be on the board, there are two equivalent size big moves available. One will gonna give slight pressure to the group, the other doesn't. I guess then the choice is clear. Even if there are two big moves, one is slightly bigger, the other one is smaller, but the relatively smaller one, not a lot, the relatively smaller one, we're gonna give some pressure. You're gonna pick that one. So to gradually gather these kind of circumstances. Yes, that's correct. That's correct. But remember, for example, okay, I can play a move to attack it, but that's obviously a small one. And there's obviously a bigger one elsewhere on the board. You can't pick the smaller one. Why? Because that's typical what we call you are paying for investment. And well, I'm saying actually if you really want to, you can do that. But you can see how risky it is, because then there's a question. Are you confident to get your investment back? That is a relatively dangerous strategy. It's possible if you are confident, but you'd better consider about it carefully. So here, for example, if you ask me on this board, what white should do? This board is actually rather difficult. Yeah, if you ask me on this board, I may just take this one. This one is a big one. This one also more or less take away black potential eye shape there. And let's see. The rest of it, we can only say, let's see. I hope this example is clear from this sense. Okay, here, I hope it is important. I earlier have introduced the method. When there's a situation happens, don't easily just tell yourself, okay, what am I gonna do? Don't easily ask yourself the move. Feel the flow. Tell yourself in general, what is the story may happen next. And then ask yourself, is that good or not? Before you make any move decision. Yeah, first you may actually choose direction and to show you yourself a few moves ahead. Both sides just play normal moves, nothing astonishing, nothing interesting, nothing fun, just the normal moves. Tell yourself, okay, so here this is the picture and how it is like. This is the method before you make any decision. I hope that's clear. Okay, then I think, let's say to Inazuma, this is your game. Then you know what is going on here. Yeah, you just kept attacking it very hard. Actually, your opponent didn't answer it correctly, completely. But like this, finally the attacking is over. You can see that through the attacking, you get nothing. Yeah, you kept attacking. You almost get nothing. I can't say you get nothing. You probably get a little bit of points here. You get this panuki. That's it. Yeah. So compared to this, you'd rather just leave it there because this income is almost none. Okay, so you would rather just leave it there. Yes. Okay. All right. Okay, I hope this example is clear. If so, we're gonna enter the second one. All right. Yeah, all right. And the second one. Yeah. I'm sorry. Second one is here. All right. So this is once again from Inazuma's example. And the question is how to attack the left side of black four stones. Am I right? Yeah. All right. So how to attack those four? All right. Okay. Once again. So here, oh, we want to attack those four. We don't talk about any specific move yet. I want you to just place some stones there on the direction of attacking, and I want you to feel the flow. And here, I hope in your mind you may prepare, because here for white only has one way. White want to attack it. I'm not saying this is white only way, but this is a question. So here, the question is, should white attack, or how white should attack if the answer is yes? Okay, so here, yeah, this is the situation. So we assume white way will be white want to attack. In that case, white has only one way. Please note, black has more than one way. And I want you to feel the flow. Just look into the next few moves. Tell yourself what we're gonna happen next. I hope you remember the method. Just do as that method. All right. Elton. Elton. Okay, I get it. Okay. Don't beat me, okay? Sorry, don't beat me. You said deny would be a prop move. I think we can do it and then see. Okay, I have to say, I'm sure that's a prop move. A prop move normally means you play a move and you can put the opponent into dilemma. So the opponent doesn't know what exactly he should answer. If you play that peep, what do you think that black will gonna answer? Is that just like he is in some kind of dilemma that he doesn't know how to answer? If that is the case, that is a problem. I'm sorry, I'm answering questions one by one, yeah? I actually noticed what Street Play and what Nils has said, but yeah, let me answer one by one. First, I'm gonna ask, don't beat me. Well, yeah, that's actually a possibility, right? But okay, doesn't matter. Don't make me, let me just ask you a simple question. Do you think when you peep, there's any chance Black may just connect? So when you peep at D9, Black answer at D10. Sorry, yeah, Black answer at D10. Do you think Black will gonna do that? Or will you do that if you're Black? Yes, if Black want to answer, Black will wanna answer at C9, right? Okay, D8, that's pretty good. I would say, for example, you may also imagine somebody might answer C8. Yeah, so here, I know that in our group, we have some dumb players and some cute players, and so I try to actually tell all the possibilities which may not be the best move, okay? So, okay, did you see that? When white peep there, Black might just answer around some other moves, but it will not be D9. So still, do you still think D9 is a good question? Because basically D9 gave Black a lot of options, a lot of good options. Okay, Inazuma, yeah, this is actually something important and we have learned before. Whenever you are about to make a peep or the opponent has just come to peep you, what is the procedure, remember? Yeah, we have learned this. First thing should be, will he even answer me, right? Yeah, when I peep the opponent, the worst thing possible will be, he doesn't even answer me, I'm bluffing. Or, what I'm doing is actually meaningless. Yeah, that kind of peep. Yeah, this is the worst kind of peep. And then it will be, can the opponent make a good exchange? Before he has to connect. Yes. Yeah, so of course here you can't directly play at D9. Okay, so I guess about that part is done. And I will show something simple maybe. Let's say here, I just throw a stone here, okay? I just throw a stone here. Okay, so here on the left side, Black, yeah, white is attacking Black. If you look at the circumstances, if you were Black, well, you're gonna fight it. So we'll run out that Black group and fight against the D7 if you look at the circumstances. So I think Black we're gonna run out, all right. Okay, I can see here there are different ideas. Somebody suggests we should let those two go. Some others suggest we should run. Okay, but I guess we can see both scenario here, maybe. All right, so if Black want to run, I guess this Sunday, I guess we can just play it, right? And then, yeah, we just play simple moves, okay? So we just run out from here. And white just goes away from here, like run out here. Okay, I guess you can already see a flow like this. If it's like this, Black Connor got hurt, isn't it? Okay, that's another question then. How much will you do like Katen? Because if you're gonna move out that K11 stone, it means Black will gonna create another group himself while left side is not alive. And if you, yeah, let's say here's actually, yeah, I didn't do that. At this moment, whenever peep, this connection must be done because Black has already decided to run, then, yeah, let's say, yeah, then actually those stones will be heavy. So they must, yeah, those stones must run. Okay, so here, yeah. So you will have another group. Your left side group is not alive. You're already paying in the corner. Do you really think this is a good flow? This is not a good flow, right? Because Black is too busy. Yeah, you are claiming I can play at the K10. Why do you be busy? Never forget, in Go, yeah, Go is a game about relative terms. So you don't always say, I am busy or he is busy. Yeah, the question is the opponent busier? If you are busy, the opponent is busier, you are not busy. Let's go. All right, and let's look at another picture. Okay, let's look at another picture because someone else of you has suggested those stones are not so big. We can let it go. So we can let it go. I guess we can just keep it small, right? I will just show simple moves again. Okay, so now connect. And I can see the second line honey is still sending, right? Okay, so I just show simple moves. I just run like this. I mean, is that? Yeah, I mean, Inazuma, you said, it is a big sacrifice, it is. It is really a big sacrifice. And I want you to look at the corner, the bottom. Actually, Black last move may not actually be here. I'm just showing simple moves. Yeah, earlier you said it is too deep, too big to sacrifice those four. Is it? And I hope you notice, as Black, I didn't play any moves that is like pro move or outstanding move, or this move is amazing. I didn't. I'm just showing simple moves as flow. Of course, in your games, when you really play as Black, you're gonna go into detail about, for example, here, we're just gonna sacrifice. Can we maybe decent? And so make white capturing harder? That's a possibility. Okay? And you may also consider after white connect here, okay, how about we just protect the corner better and in the center white over move there anyway? Yeah, we can. Yeah, you can think about those details when you are really playing the game. But I'm saying at this moment, or actually at this moment, you say, what are we gonna attack? Please, in your mind, you're supposed to show those kind of simple move picture. Tell yourself, is that good? That is the flow. When I was preparing this lecture, okay, yeah, that's actually from one of my friends' advice. I am watching Hikaru no Go again, and Japanese sound like that. I'm watching that. In one of the episodes, that was one of the early episodes, Sai actually told Hikaru, please feel the flow. Can you feel something? I want to tell you, this is actually what Sai ask Hikaru to feel. Just feel the flow, the moves, and it's ongoing. Feel it. Are you able to feel it now? You can see the following moves, they are simple. Yeah, you just think about simple moves, nothing complicated, nothing outstanding. About those detailed things that you're supposed to think about when it really happened. But when you're just designing for things, no need to be too much into detail. Just those kind of, you know, just those kind of general plan, that is enough. Yeah. So here, yeah, after the invasion, we already can feel, in case Black run, What will be the scenario? What if black will just choose to sacrifice? How is it like? Okay, so finally, we say black run may not be a good choice, but black can easily sacrifice it. And then it is actually not so good for white at all. It's too small. So conclusion, should white attack at all? Yeah, okay, yeah. So after you have, for example, yes, if you have determined, okay, attacking is good, I should invade here to attack. You have determined. All right, now we should look into it. What is the best attacking move? Should it be the move Jeff has showed here? Or maybe I should go a little one line further here. I don't think this is good. Actually, I believe if we really want to attack, this is the best move. But yeah, after you feel the flow, you have determined, okay, this is the thing I'm gonna do. Then you look into which move exactly I'm gonna play. Rather than, yeah, the common mistake to us is, okay, so here I'm gonna attack, which move I'm gonna play. You know, that is a common mistake. You directly jump towards which move I'm gonna play. Yes, exactly. The details may vary, but in general, the picture will not gonna change. So see a general picture first. If the general picture is good, then you look into detail. But that's second step. First, to see the picture. Exactly. Yeah, first feel the flow. And when you feel the flow, remember, just the simple moves. Yeah, and I hope you are, I'm not sure if everyone can do that. I hope when you feel the flow about the following version, the next few moves, in your mind, there is a goban that show you about those simple moves. You need to be able to do this. What if both simple results seems not good though? Then you have to think about something else. But okay, there are those kind of situations. Well, I have considered about all the possibilities. They are all bad. There are those possibilities. Then what you should do? Then it is basically like, you know, recently we are facing to some elections. We have faced to some elections and we are facing to those choices. There are only bad candidates. Which one I should choose? You have to be realistic and pick one that is not that bad. Okay, how do you practice to do this? How do you practice to do this? I would say, to practice to do this is not so difficult because in your games, there are so many this kind of attack and defense situations. It's just so many. Whenever it comes to this, please do not just enjoy and go if you want to get a practice. Just as what I have suggested, first step, sit back, relax, look at the whole area or even the whole board, and then tell yourself, yeah, what am I gonna do? What I want to do. And then according to what you want to do, show some simple moves. Show the opponent response some simple moves. See the next few moves as a flow. Then you know what you should do. You just have to do this as the right procedure rather than I'm enjoying my game. Don't disturb me. I'm gonna play this game, all right? Well, if you are just enjoying the game, there can't possibly be any this kind of practice. Niels, I don't think Jusek is suited here. Jusek is more about direction. Yeah, but it is actually, yeah, there are similarities. You first think about direction. Yeah, which direction is good, and then you consider into detail about what exactly you should do. Then, yeah, from that sense, it is similar. You can don't you might actually just have one scenario. For example, here, in this case, white is thinking I'm gonna attack, and if as you're thinking it is in general good, well, you can go for it. if you think it's good, you can go for it. In this way, the deficit is only, well, your way might be good, but actually there are better ways and you didn't consider. Yeah, but if it is good, it is after all good. So that's at least not the worst idea. Okay, yeah, so here, if you ask what should do, this board actually is pretty positive to white already because of this whole board situation. And if I were white, I would slightly worry about, for example, because black just play this K mark here on the top side, and this stone might run out. Yeah, so how about we just K mark here? So to protect, this is an idea. And if you say, okay, I don't think that's a problem, you just play the big move, yes, that's fine. Yeah, depends on how you judge about it. I think white is fine at this moment because actually this stone can be captured. Yeah, so white, probably white should just tanuki for now. But those four stone on the left side, as you can see, is really small. And how do you see that? Yeah, we just white try to capture and see a flow next. Okay, I guess this example is clear. Okay, good. Okay, I should tell this actually that so those are the two examples. We say, okay, as our judgment, as we see the flow, our decision is, I'm gonna attack it. No, I'm not gonna attack it. Yeah, those are the examples here, and I have given them all. In the following, we are gonna see other examples, and I should tell you at once that I didn't really prepare the examples evenly. It's mainly because the examples, the majority of the examples are actually from Inazuma and Fuss, and I'm trying to answer as many questions as possible out from their examples. So it is unevenly. And I hope you don't mind in some examples I didn't give enough. And if you want any later after the lecture, we will still have a question and an answer part. And I'd like to answer your questions if you have any examples from your own game. Okay. Okay, good. Okay, now we come to the next example. Let me see here. So it is this one. And this is a given position. All right. Okay, so white has just invaded here, and the question is, how black should attack it? Can we do as the method I have introduced as a practice? Yeah, I remember someone has mentioned you want a practice. This is not your game. You are not under pressure. You are not going to move too much in the game. This is relaxed circumstances. Do as a procedure and tell me what do you think. Yes, this is your game, Fuss. As I said, I tried to include as many examples as possible from your questions and from from Inazuma's. I think I only deleted one. Yeah, that one is one really, yeah, I really don't think I really don't think that's a good example. Yes. Okay, here I think it is not difficult for us to reach a conclusion that the black should play p17, but that didn't answer the entire question, because p17, the first move might be easy. But here our question is, well, I want you to feel the flow and tell me, as for a long-term plan, how this attacking should be implemented. Okay, left. Oh.
After reading every one of your comment, I think I'd better make my question clear. My question here is, after p17, will black continue to attack? And if so, what will be the direction in general you're gonna attack, and what is the benefit? Or you may just choose to keep white weak and leave it there. That's the two choices. Yeah, rather than, okay, I'm gonna play this move, that move, and that move. Yeah, this looks good, that is not good. For how long you plan to continue the attacking? And what is your intention of the attacking? And to Niels, I'm quite sure P7 is better. Because your top side, that three space extension structure, is considered as a strong structure, you shouldn't worry about it. So P17, through the attacking, you get more point out of it. Top side is limited. Okay, you want to keep attacking, then what is your plan in general for the attacking, and what do you think will be the benefit you can get after p17? Because we already know p17 is one move, we already get the corner, that is benefit, but where's your further benefit? It could, and Niels, I can tell you, when I'm doing this kind of game myself, sometimes it is a struggling, but we do what is right, not how we feel. Because Go is a pure rational game. All right, so maybe let's look into some detail, okay? We just feel the flow, nothing else. Okay, so this one might jump out. And those who suggest the black should keep attacking, could you tell, may I ask, how you're gonna keep doing this? Just as the natural moves. I guess we don't need to think too much. This peep should be done, because this will gonna make white heavy. So yeah, let's make this peep done. And then you may keep attacking, but my question is, what will be your benefit? If you have a concrete plan here, go ahead. And then O13, huh? Okay, you play O13, I guess, what, just simply, just play the that without too much thinking. Continue, please. Just show the flow. Are you saying you're gonna attack from here? And then white jump here. You are gonna re-enhance the right side. So basically, you are this one extension, and then you're gonna leave it there. Am I right? Okay. So how you're gonna play on the right? Something like this. Okay. This is a plan, but this plan has one deficit. So you are saying this one move helps to defend the right side. Okay. And my question is, how much does it defend the right side? For example, now if one just jump out here, will you add another move on the right? You were not gonna add a move on the right side. Then I guess you cannot deny the possibility in the future when white play at A, your this stone may not really function enough to capture it. Yeah, and white get out because, okay, I'll take away this mark, I'll use those two mark. This exchange, never forget. Yeah, you keep attacking a group that is not killable. It means every single exchange, you are actually making the opponent either or struggle. And the question is, how much those exchange benefit yourself? White did spend two moves, but he is a weak group here, so his every single move values. And also here, we're gonna raise another question. It is about, is black topside reliable after white get those two moves? Okay, you didn't see much benefit. True, because B is a defensive move. The value is white get strong himself. If you ask the value, it doesn't mean anything for points. But you know, in Go we say, you get points or you get influence, that is plus value. And we enhance a weak group, we protect a cutting point. Yeah, those are the things that potentially I will gonna lose points. So that is minus value, and you have to treat them equally. And actually, Go series told us in the middle game, in fact, you should emphasize more on the minus value. And here you can see, B is in general a defensive move, so as the jump at M12. But then black topside become weaker. You can't say C is impossible, right? I just show an example. Okay, I need to throw a black move somewhere. I'm sorry, I didn't mean black should play there, but I just throw a move here. Okay, so why do you make this one? Honey, Atari here, and a run. At this moment, the white topside already get some sort of base, and the black still need to come back here, right? When you look at this picture, yeah, shouldn't you say white actually get points on the top? White get points, and white get eye shape. His group is no longer weak. So after, yeah, then will you still say those two moves doesn't value? Yes, all right. That's pretty good. So you're gonna add another move to defend the top side. In that case, you have already admitted those two moves are valuable because they are threatening black top. You are very right. So here we are. What we are talking about is a detail difference. So here, question is, this exchange, how much does black has protected the right? And how much does white threat the top? You are very right that white threat to black top side is not very high. And my question is your this move as protection for the right side is high? They are both pretty low. So question is it worth it? So normally, you know, here, if you check out a pro game here,
Okay, I will directly tell you my answer. Maybe if you check pro game here, the attacking move is actually similar to straight play's way, but it's a more realistic way. The way is more like this way to attack. You may say this is Tanuki, but this, okay, do you remember earlier I've told you on the board, let's say, when we say, okay, that group is weak, but I didn't find any direct way to attack, I'm gonna Tanuki. So you're supposed to still play the big move down the board. And when there are some equivalent size, big moves existing on the board, you're gonna play the one that gives your opponent some pressure. So did you see that? Will you say this move is giving no pressure to white top side? Or will you say here like this, white there Tanuki? I guess it is still very necessary for white to play a move like this, right? Then even this, I mean, like this, black protect the red side a lot better than your player stone at O13. So here, let's say the threat doesn't need to be, it is like, I want to threat somebody in real life. Do you have to go to his door, say, I am gonna attack you? I guess a phone call is enough, even if you are hundreds of kilometers away, right? What we're not gonna play there now. So what do we mean? Doesn't matter. Yeah, this kind of discussion is very healthy. Okay. Well, I'm sorry. This move, I'm just giving an example as a comparison to the earlier. I mean, if you put the stone at O13. Yeah, actually black, yeah, not necessary play there. We know that it's unnecessary. For example, black might just jump this one. So here, I'm saying here, let's say the way to attack, this is a way to threat. But actually, we can consider this way as Tanuki. So basically, after we get the benefit on the top side, we temporarily kind of just leave it there. Because you do not have any direct way to attack. So temporarily just leave it there. And actually, you can actually further get a benefit through white, this kind of white shape that is relatively weak. So this is actually an example on, well, yeah, we are doing attacking, but we are not actually doing very close by to black. We just keep it weak. And white is the one who is responsible to add a move, so to make it stronger. It's none of our business. It is his work. Okay. All right, so this is example, this is the first situation from Fools in this situation. And I think in the game, Fools played here, to me is not bad. So you just claim direct benefit on the top side. And in the game, white answer there, it is a big benefit, but you shouldn't answer this one. Yeah, still this one. Because he cannot directly one move take the corner. He's that Q18 is just using. So in general, if you follow this line, it is good. Yeah, and also this answer is unnecessary. Yeah, you don't have to answer there. Still just, yeah, or let's say if you want to keep attacking, jump here, threat more. Okay, but that matter, I hope this example is clear because now, of course you jump to attack because your top side has enough eye shapes. You don't need to play this tiger. So to claim for yourself more eye shape, you're alive already. Yeah. Okay, but now let's come to the second situation. Yeah, this is a second situation here. So, because we actually come from the top side situation here, I guess now you have a better impression about what is going on. Okay, note white top side is not alive yet. White evade again. Okay, can you feel the flow here? I'm sorry, Nils, you said you directly start with Q. I don't get exactly what you mean. And also, please, yeah, does anyone else has any opinion here? Yeah, please. Okay, don't beat me. I have to tell in your this law, there's one flaw. Yeah, your other analysis is correct, but there's one obvious flaw. The flaw is normally if we get a two-space extension, that group is in general considered as safe. In general. Ina Zuma, I just want to remark. When you say I want to push those two groups together and then rush from the middle, so in order to attack both, that is a very nice dream. If that dream can come true, that's my reminder. And we are facing two reality. Can we get it? Yeah, you can't just say, I really want that dream to happen. Even though I didn't see that dream, I'm going to make it happen. Don't. Yeah, do what you can do, please. Okay. Nils, you are asking a good question, actually. you can attack the top side first or to attack the right side first. But here, okay, I believe I have already introduced the method. No matter where you attack first, please show yourself the next few moves, see the flow or feel the flow, and then compare the two ways. Ask yourself which one is better. That's the method. Nobody wants them to connect, and I believe White really want to connect, but I didn't see how. Those two groups are really far away each other, right? So, okay, let me make it clear. So, some said this flow earlier, this is actually the game flow. So, White has two groups that is under attack. This is a simple one. And this is what you want to suggest, Nils. Q9. Q9.
Okay, here to represent white, I ask a black a question, okay? Because this is basically a black method to attack. Are you sure on the red side through this attacking, you are gonna get Sene as black? You don't worry about I'm gonna leave in Sene. Can you see a flow like that? Just feel the flow. Your this method will be really good if you say white has to live on the red side. You go to get some center stones. Then finally I play at M11. Perfect. Can you feel the flow about white might live on the red side? That's your biggest enemy. You can get Sene. All right, let's see the flow here. So, okay, you are basically saying you see a variation because to me the flow is. Yeah, because we said when we see the flow, we just look into. And you are basically saying you see something more sophisticated. Like honey here or what? One point jump, right. So if when wedge, Atari, connect, you're gonna directly come over here, huh? Perfect, yeah. Then this is a good plan. This might be a relatively risky plan, but this is a good plan. I hope you are confident to capture this part on the top. Yeah, if this is your plan, perfect. All right, yeah, then you can do it. Yeah, then I would say, yeah, you can see here. Okay, earlier I showed this flow. This is mainly, I showed this flow is actually for the majority of our participants today here, because yeah, this is something just simple and it's not, yeah, so we can see. Black, this plan is actually difficult to implement. But here, to Niels at his level, he actually sees something relatively sophisticated, and he is able to implement this plan. If you see it, you can do it. Yeah, but one of our common mistake is actually, we feel like this can be done. However, we don't know how to do it. And then we say, it feels like it can be done, let's do it. I won't tell, that's the worst. You need to see this picture just like what Niels did. Then you can do it. Yeah, otherwise don't. Yeah, so here I would say this is a really good plan. Jump here first. Yeah, if so, it doesn't matter, then you just show the simple move like this. This is still a double attack, and white groups are still running towards each other. So white is still in a difficult position. This is pretty good too. Yeah, this is actually the variation I want to show to the majority of our participants today. Yeah, if you can handle it, you do it. If you can't handle it, do it. And that is why I just say, I just want you to, in general, feel the flow, because that's relatively easier. Otherwise, you have to look into it. No, you didn't. Niels, that's pretty good. That is pretty good. I appreciate that. Yeah, because... Is it mainly, yeah, because here, when you advance, you basically told us, you can do it. When you can do it, you do it, good. But if you can't do it, then don't. It's just this simple. So here, you showed people that is an idea and it's doable, but it requires them to see it. Yeah. if you really want the V group to run towards each other, so you can this goes to me one move, you're actually hurting both groups. Okay. I guess we are pretty clear about this example in general. But I have to say, Fuss, what you did in the game, seriously, is not too bad because you are also threatening both groups like this. Yeah, it's just here, probably you should do execution. You already have two stones on the right, so I can't see why to survive. All right, okay, let's go to the next example, all right? Yeah, white has zero eye here, and white we're gonna potentially run towards black red side. On black red side, in general, the structure is strong. Like this, white is pretty hopeless. Okay, but let's go to the next one, all right? Yeah, we already cost half time. Here, let me see. Okay, so this is a question situation. So what just has done the invasion? Okay, so here we normally say, let's say you just fill the floor and then look into how you're gonna, in different ways, how you're gonna attack it. Here, before we feel that, we have to answer a question, because here, this is a question white has advanced. White is saying, I am going to connect at S10. So this is a question we first have to answer. I believe here, we need to separate it, right? Because if we don't separate, there won't be any attack. Don't beat me, that's too early. I guess you heard me about S10. We have to answer that question first. Yeah, we have to answer S10 first. Nils, you are trying to tell me like S13? That can be a good one, but that also can be challenged. That can be challenged, but yeah, so I'm saying that is probably relatively complicated. So in my preparation, that is not a scenario I have prepared. Yes, the challenge will gonna hurt the top right. I'm not sure who will gonna be hurt. Because then basically, you know, we say R8 stone initially is a weak one. After that variation, white challenge, white on the right is in general alive. And after you separate there, top right area is not alive, but after all, it is white move first because black needs to fix the cutting point. I guess you understand what I'm saying. Yeah. Kick at 11, okay. Red bomb at R12. Black strength Q10. Strength at Q10 looks weird. Q11, alright. Alright, let's take this scenario first. Okay, so yeah. This, huh? Here I have a question to you about me. Do you have any intention against the white top right area group? Do you think that group is not alive? It is online, right? Yes, okay. In that case, your this last Q11 stone is basically under the intention you want to save Q12. But even if you save Q12, right there, that area is alive anyway. So this Q12 stone is only points. Yeah, this is actually in one of my lesson to my student I have mentioned. On the Go board, or let's say in a planet named Go, the rule is very different from the world we are living at. Some stones are not considered as stones. They are under the level compared to some other stones here. So Q12 is not a stone. Q12 is only points. It's similar as in real life. We say somebody is not a people. Yeah, he is already disabled. He cannot really contribute to our society. He's not a people. I mean, this word sounds very wrong here in our world. But in Go planet, that's the rule. So here, Q12 stone, it's only points. Then why you care about to save it? You should actually consider more about to give pressure to our eight. Yeah, you may say it's faster. I would say this because our major work here is to give pressure to this R8. It's not to save Q12. Nobody care about 12. I don't even think white care. Yeah, so since nobody care about it, yeah, then we just leave it there. Yeah, so this is clearer, right? Okay, so starting from here, I guess now we can feel the flow. Yeah, this can be a scenario. I will take this for an example. There can be some other ways to separate, but yeah, let's just take this one as an example. Let's feel the flow, please. Don't bind me. If you remember earlier, I have mentioned about how we are not going to play any moves that can be described as weird or sophisticated. We only play simple moves. If you say you're going to play at P5, I have to say P5 and R8, those two stones combination looks pretty weird. That is the wrong shape. That's better. Yeah, talking about your plan rather than moves. That goes first, then moves. Yes. Yeah, that it is one move now, yes. So you need to feel okay, white will probably just do this and then I will just do that, see the next few moves. White doesn't have to save that stone. Okay. Then there's a question. Why he invaded there on the red side right at the first place? And is his intention just to die there? Especially after black jump at P10, red side become bigger. That might be the case, yes, but you did it, and then you say, I will let it die. Yeah, it is possible that invasion mistake, yes. Okay. Okay, I will just show a simple variation, all right? So we just show it simply as, okay, we don't talk about it too complicated. We just think about it logically. What you made it, what we're gonna save it, okay? And we think from black perspective, okay? So he run it like this, okay? So we attack. He run it, we attack. Yeah, this is in general the flow, right? Yep, you can see, I just do the attacking without too much thinking. I just see this flow. Yeah, but the guy is totally surrounded. He need to live, and where he can live, I guess he will need to, for example, seek for some eye shape around here, right? Yeah, so he will need to live in this small area. I mean, I want you to look at this area between those two stones, this area, who want it? If we don't talk about life and death, who want to get this area? No? Okay, you didn't get my question. If we do not talk about life and death, we just talk about to get points, will anyone want to take that area? The answer is nobody, right? Nobody want to get it. So here, we force white to come to this area to make eyes to live there. Well, we consolidate the corner, we will consolidate the bottom because why the red side is not alive. He dare not create another big group. Through the attacking, corner is will potentially be consolidated, bottom side will potentially be consolidated, and very likely this double kama shape will be consolidated. We are no longer a big group ourselves. So here, you just see this flow. Should we attack? We should. Go ahead. Ah. The problem is, what is the one who has invaded there at the first place? So logically, we assume he will gonna continue. Yeah, otherwise, I mean, after this jump, you'll say, I'm not gonna continue. That stone is just that. Then why I invaded at the first place? Then we just keep it the flat, and there's a step left still, right? Yeah, so probably, yeah, you're right here that this emission itself is not right, but after that, logically, what we're gonna continue, because I want you to imagine in a game, yeah, when you are playing a game, will you say, I have just played that move, and then I realize, yeah, that move is silly, I shouldn't have done that. Let's immediately switch plan. That rarely happens. If someone believes I am right, even if he's wrong, he only realized that after the game. Yeah, so it is more logical. We just assume, yeah, right here, we're gonna run on the black. Yeah, here, question is, should black keep attacking or should black leave it? Here, black should keep attacking easily because black will directly get a benefit. You are, okay, but once again, this is earlier what I have mentioned and in the last example, and this is important. Are you able to see, yeah, when I say, this one is simple, right? Like this, yeah, you have already surrounded white, and white will need to seek for a living on the red side, in that desert area nobody wants. Okay, I see this picture. I showed you this. Are you able to see it? Please remember, please never forget. For example, a very strong player or a pro player might show you a variation. Hey, you should do like this. Yeah, why you don't do like this? This is a good opportunity. He might be right. But next time when you meet a similar situation, when you are in the game, did you see it in the game? If you do, do it. If you don't, don't. So here, the thing is, yeah, in this picture, white runs. If black see that picture, go ahead. If black didn't see that picture, leave it. At least the white is still weak. Okay, I hope here I'm giving a very practical advice because I'm here talking about this. I haven't considered we have a different level participants, and yeah, some of you can see something very complicated, some of you just cannot. Okay, remember, this is in general, yeah, this is in general the principle you follow. Can you see it? Okay. Well,
after playing more games by following this procedure, your eyes will be open. For now, you might feel like you are blind, but gradually it will be open. You need more related experience. Yes. Okay. Yes, just feel it. Also, when you, for example, when you watch pro games, especially those, for example, on YouTube, there are those kind of NHK cup. When you watch those games, for example, feel it, especially come to this kind of attack and defense situation. Feel it and see, what you can feel. And better, you still just click pause at some point when you want to feel. And then after you reach your conclusion, click resume and see if your feeling is the same as how the pro player feel. That is good practice. Okay, I guess this one is clear. Shall we go to the next? I hope we can go to the next. Because it is still in this game tree and we have another example. Onward, and we are here. This is actually a similar example as another situation earlier, but the question is that the same? Or, is that exactly the same? I hope you notice. Okay, so here, we can already reach a conclusion. This should be done. You jump here. This peep and the connection should be done. That's exactly what happened in the game. And now, I hope you'll notice that in the last situation, on the top side, we have a very comfortable extension to threat black. Now we do not. Yes, and also, the top side situation is different. Okay, I want you to have your plan. Different people might have a different plan. And I want you to have your plan and feel the flow. Remember, it requires you see it. Okay. Aesna is pretty big. Yes, I agree. Aesna is very big. But it doesn't matter. But Aesna is actually irrelevant from this question. Okay. Okay. Who's at the L6 thing? I'm sorry. Before chasing at G12. So if he does this one, you're gonna G12. So don't bite me, said that, right? I'm surprised because this is exactly what I'm thinking about, but I didn't really expect. Anyone may directly tell me this, because this is a very brief plan. This is exactly the one I have in my mind. And you directly test on the top side of this attachment. This is actually on the direction of a black potential escaping. You ask black, will you give me the money? You give the money, I will let you go. Or I'm gonna shoot you. So this is a good question. And in case black say no, you get nothing. Don't expect anything. They have no choice but to shoot.
And about the C12 plan, this is what I want to say. So this is about some details on the left side. On the left side, black can at the most go this far, which means you can see between C10 and C6, that area is always black is always white territory. That will not gonna be affected. And black cannot go this far because of this. So you can see push here, kick, cut, and get connection. So from this sense, C12 is not very big because left side is in general your territory. C12, you are just taking an extra bit more. About, let's say, you may say, after I do like this, he came, he can get I shape. He can, but it's not enough for him to live. Especially here, in this case, you're gonna answer in this way. So he can, but limited. So C12, let's say on this board, if you say I'm just gonna defend and he can run. Possible, but I will comment as this is a passive way. I would rather hear your Tanuki. I would say Tanuki is better than C12. C12 is slow. Yeah, for example, here if you say I jump down here. Or actually, new step. This one, I would rather your Tanuki is better than C12. Yeah. Let's say here Tanuki is a possibility, but I have to say this is actually, let's say, you invite a pro player here in this lecture and you ask, what do you think, sir? He will probably directly show you this variation. He just said, what you guys are talking about? Let's just do the attack. Yeah, so like this, actually, black whole group is eyeless. He will need to struggle there. And in case, okay, this is the flow. Here I didn't see any moves, but this is the flow I can see. Black will need to struggle there to live. And we already know B11 is not enough to supply him two eyes on the left side at least. He will definitely need to struggle to get eye shape in the center, which will gonna supply white relatively strong center shape. And then, after the whole attacking is done, white center can be relatively strong. Then white jump over here. And Niels, I hope you notice, this is the way, this is actually the way I want to introduce for white to manage the red side group. Because this A is not only a reduction to the bottom, but also after white center is strong, that can be a threat to black group. Is that understandable about the flow I have introduced? Yeah, okay. In your games, okay, sometimes you can show a few moves and so you can see a flow. Sometimes you can't see those moves, but you can see a tendency of the whole thing. Yeah, a tendency. Maybe not exactly what may happen next, but in general, in general, things will gonna happen on this line. And this is a flow you can feel too. And this can be important as for your judgment. Okay, I guess about this whole thing, we can finish here and we can go to the next one. Yeah, today we have a lot of examples. Okay, let's go to the next one and come over here. If you don't mind, give me a minute to check this. 31. Oh, sorry. Okay. 24, huh? I'm sorry. This is the question. Okay, so what has just invaded? This is a relatively more normal situation. So yes, let's say on this board, I can see probably there are two moves that are slightly off. The rest are in general on the red position. Yeah, that K16, I would say only K16 actually. K16 is slightly off. Okay, and then what you made here? Can you feel something? Feel it. You can't feel anything and frustrating because you don't know how to attack it. Fools, I have to ask you a question because this is from game. Let's say my question is probably a tip to you. The tip is, are you sure you don't know how to attack? Or actually you are saying you don't know how to kill? Have you thought about this? You can't see a way to profit. Okay, what do you mean as for important actually? Yes, but Niels, I have to ask you a question. That idea is based on an assumption. What will lobby? Will what lobby? Yes. Lobby is all for all the people. Okay. all right. No, it's small. Okay, that is a pretty good flaw. Inazuma, that is a pretty good flaw, actually. However, I hope you notice your O6 is at a very high position there. When you are saying you keep pressure, I want you to stand at a wide position because you are playing black. You may not feel as much, let's say, standing at a wide position. I actually want you to try to feel if you are wide, how much pressure you are feeling. And then you may actually understand how much pressure O6 has given. Don't easily change your mind. Yeah, if you have a plan, see it through rather than you directly change your plan. It's quite a bit of pressure. All right. Okay. Then yeah, if you feel it that way, then why will we go? Inazuma, you know, we have learned about. I mean, in Go, what does huge mean? Okay, we have a few different scenario here. So I hope I will answer one by one. And since this game, I will start from his opinion. So who's want to just do this? And you feel like black, well, yeah, you're gonna jump here, and you're gonna go for Q7, like this, huh? All right. So first, this is what I want to say. Normally in this kind of shape, if white runs as a natural shape, white should probably came here. So to prevent this one, you'll get a peep if you have choices. Yeah, so you may consider this one. You might also consider all gamma. Sometimes you may consider two space jump, not here. Yeah, but you may consider those moves. And okay, doesn't matter. Yeah, no matter which one, do you think this one is really some pressure to white? Oh yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, in this case, shoulder is definitely our choice. Yeah, and if I show this this one, this will gonna disappoint the fools even more, because then my same question is Q7 any pressure? Then it's zero. Yeah, then it's zero. Yeah, but yeah, this shoulder pretty good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that plan is probably too loose. It's possible, but a little bit too loose. Let me see. I will go for conduct first. So this one and came, all right? Okay. I will follow you a little bit. Continue, please. I'm just playing natural moves. I hope you also play natural moves. This move is natural, right? I hope this move doesn't surprise you too much. Peep and cut is based on the fact that white will connect. So, you know, peep, how about he attach here? Okay, yeah, well, this is still seem fine to you. So how are you gonna continue? I'm three, all right. You are happy to get third, right? Okay, this is actually pretty boring, Nils. Yeah, if this is your plan, you can see this is pretty boring. You only get third line. And so, for example, white just. And you're this third line, potentially there can be a problem. Okay, I'm here, I'm saying here, potential problem. The potential problem can be like this. So there's a cutting point. So for example, white knows. Okay. Yeah, I will say here, if you are doing that attacking, you only make white stronger. I don't know what your plan is, but that's pretty disappointing in general. Yeah, that's not a good attacking plan. Compared to you get third line, I'd rather you just leave it there. Because you leave it there, it's more than you get third line. Third line basically means you only get the distance between those two, and yeah, that area is very small, right? And note, you didn't just get them for free. You make one stronger. Yeah, so as I said, I don't know what exactly your plan is, but just for this trade itself, it doesn't look like a good plan. So here, remember, whenever you are saying, I'm gonna peep, yeah, as your plan, you'd better prepare. What if he doesn't connect as a procedure? But okay, yeah, that's actually, our that discussion is relatively too advanced. But yeah, Kendall, I'm sorry, I didn't see your flaw yet. Okay, so you're gonna jump here. Yeah, that's a natural flaw. We're gonna do this. If you're gonna do this, then I mean, okay, I'm sorry, I didn't see it. What did you say?
Okay, N6. Sorry, N6. Oh, N6. O9. Where's O9? Ah, okay. Do not push. Yeah, I'd rather you just jump one space, not push and two space. Yeah, that push hurt. Okay, but then this is actually my question earlier. So what if not white come over? Yeah, and is your pressure at O8 strong enough to that bottom group? Because your red side, I hope you notice, you are playing your stones on the sixth line. Sixth line is pretty high there. Yeah, there's too much space. And here I just place here. Actually, if we just want to show a flow, it's better this one, huh? Yeah, so this one. At least this is a risky plan because white bottom is not white top side is not very weak. Yeah, so here this is a picture. Yes. Okay, and I probably missed someone's flow here. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I can't find it anymore. Can you? So P3, I know one flow is a P3, M5, J5. J5, what is J5? J5, this one. M7 and P7. So this is from okay. This flow has a similar problem. Actually, this problem has more problem. So first, this move is kind of like dummy. It doesn't do anything. And the second about this one, I hope you notice you are playing on the fifth line. Fifth line is basically you are standing or you are putting your feet on cloud. And so, yeah, it feels good, but you are not really getting anything. So below your feet is not earth, it's cloud. She will shoulder hit at G4 and then J4. Okay, I get what you mean though. So yeah, saying if black, for example, Taluki and play something like this. Do this. Sorry, give me a moment. This. Well, okay, this is a possibility. Problem is, this kind of a connection is considered as a connection, but as a white, I want you to feel it as a white. Don't you feel like your muscle is tight? Do you understand what I mean? Your muscle is tight. There are people who, for example, didn't really sleep well last night, and when he wake up, he may feel like on his leg. The muscles immediately feel so tight, and then there can be a sudden pain, and you need to stretch it in order to get rid of the pain. Okay, and I hope you understand what I'm talking about your tight. And here, even if the case white feel the muscle is tight. So, for example, black wedge. I hope you notice the cutting point, the white shortage of liberty. So this is a connection. Does white really want this sort of connection? Or as white, how about we just get things done slowly without this kind of tight muscle or even slower? I would rather prefer this way rather than that kind of tight muscle, but we want to make things done immediately. Yeah, here once again I'm showing simple moves. So we can discuss about detail. For example, can white attach here? Yeah, or can white shoulder here? But I'm saying I would prefer this way rather than we just get things directly done with very tight muscle, because that normally means potential trouble. Okay. Yeah, all right. So yeah, I might actually introduce about my version. Okay. No. I'm sorry, I have to answer about the left side. Okay, I hope you understand where is it? Sorry. This version, huh? Okay, here when I showed this wedge, please never forget this is one possibility. This is only one possibility. I'm saying black, white has this sort of problem. For example, black can also attack white shape like this turn. Yeah, and when I show this turn, will you still have the dream on? This will gonna help white to build the left side to make it a moyo. Will you still see that when the muscle is this tight? Yeah, but that is actually, how should I say that? That is basically about, if you say I'm doing pure investment, I'm just gonna enlarge the moyo and I'm purely enlarging the moyo. Here, actually, if white muscle is not this tight, I mean, white this way actually makes sense for his mainly trying to connect his group. And for developing the left side, that's a side issue. Yeah, so if white doesn't have this kind of tight shape, shortage of liberty with cutting point problem, if white doesn't have this problem, I would say this is a pretty good method. Question is, can white really stand on this kind of shape? Q to cut, or G to cut here, all right. And honey. Okay, once again, you ask a good question, but this once again can be complicated because, yeah, this can potentially be a trade. Yeah, I personally suggest let's not too complicated one because this will gonna, I mean, yeah, this kind of discussion will be forever. Yeah, this can potentially be a trade, but this is a good question actually. Okay, but doesn't matter. I'm gonna show actually about. All right, so let's say we kick from here. Okay, I actually like this kick better than this one because it's not because this one. Let's say how wide we're gonna answer. I mean, at the bottom after this exchange, I hope you notice compare with earlier, there's nothing. Okay, let's remember there's nothing. If there's nothing, black kind of one move get the bottom as territory, right? If after this exchange, here in general it captures, but that exchange can white black bottom potentially. For example, if white has some sort of stone on the red side, then this can run. That is the major difference here. So it is kind of like say this exchange slightly benefit white already. So in theory, we cannot rule out the possibility white tanuki, especially red side is this big. So kick is relatively more forcing. But question is, after this, can we continue the attacking? Yeah, can you see a good way to attack? Earlier I have already, like this, actually it's difficult to continue, right? So why we continue? We won't. Yeah, because right side is the biggest, we just play the biggest. While the bottom two stone is kept to be weak. So it is his issue, not ours. Yeah, actually here it is still the case. If as Kendall's idea, we continue attacking like this, we see a future, we see a bright future after this, then this is a better version. But did you see it? If you don't see it, then don't do anything. Just to play the biggest move on the board. Leave white weak. It's better than I keep attacking until it is alive.
P11. Q7? You are saying Q11 and Q7, huh? Yes, this one is bigger because your corner is relatively solid. The bottom corner is relatively solid and the top right corner is relatively weaker. I'm saying relatively. So here, yeah, you'd rather play on that, in general, on that direction. Yeah, you want to enhance your weaker group, not stronger. I have to say they are both strong, but the top right is relatively weaker, just relatively. Yeah. Okay, yeah, so this is actually, yeah, let's say how I see about this thing. But did you see that? Okay, I hope in all the examples, I stick on the method, and I hope you're gonna just repeat this method over and over again. So whenever facing to an invasion, facing to a situation, I'm gonna attack. Feel the flow. Look at the next few moves. Just the simple moves. And tell yourself, is attacking good? If you see a clear picture on, okay, I'm attacking, I'm benefiting, go ahead. If you say, I keep attacking, I can't see benefit anymore. That is actually probably the moment you should just leave it there. Don't do anything. Is that clear? Just repeat this procedure over and over again. This is your way to practice. And in general, you will get, let's say, you will get the reason about in the future, whenever we are going to do attacking, what are we going to do? Just repeat this procedure. Okay, then I guess we can go to the next. We still have several. Let's see. The long tree. Oh, I'm sorry, I missed that question. Niels, so after the lecture, we have still one question and answer session. If there's anything I didn't really get to answer here, I'm gonna answer there, all right? Right, okay, thanks. Yeah, and please remind me, I might forget it. Yeah. Okay, so we are in this kind of situation on the white plate here. And I guess after we had that many examples, this shouldn't be too difficult, I hope. Yeah, okay, folks, that is the general, the flow, you get it. But I have a question. Among all those moves that you are doing, I can see white, every single move is enhancing your group, is enhancing his group. Are you sure your every single move, you are getting something? Okay, which one you didn't? You should actually find out which one you did, which one you didn't. And then The one you didn't is a move. You should think about other way around. For example, should I do something differently? Or maybe I should just leave it there. So you are saying P11 value something. What did P11 get? Yeah, what did P11 get? Because you already got the rest of two space extension. What does P11 mean? When you say you get something, you'd better be able to explain. What did you get? Yeah. And Kendall, when you say you're gonna play at M4, that can be a plan, but I think first that plan must start from R11, since if white get a two space extension, all your imagination can be gone. That's the first. And the second, when you're gonna do at M4, what exactly do you plan to do? Because that only close a part of white running direction. Remember, you must have a concrete plan if you want to do those kind of not so simple moves. I'm sorry, folks, I don't completely understand you. If white capture P18, okay? Yeah. Oh. Well, I have to say that depends. Sometimes you're just a decent Q19. Yeah, that is the best for the corner territory. You'd better prove center value something. Yeah, if you say center value something, you jump at P14. It makes sense. Otherwise, if you don't do anything in the corner, you know that you can actually white honey. On the first line, you have to know that you can't block. Otherwise, white can leave in the corner. And then he pushes again, your corner will be reduced a lot. Reduced by a lot. So I'm not 100% sure if what you said is true. It depends. Yeah. Okay, let's come back to Kendall. Do you have any concrete plan starting from, let's say, I see a flow, this one, and then you say, I'm not going to continue attacking anymore. I'm not going to follow the simple flow anymore. And so I'm going to do this attachment. Do you have a concrete plan? Because this is not a simple move anymore. And I hope you notice why the bottom, okay? It's a two space jump and an all game shape. When you are attached there, white answers you all the way. You are doing investment. Oh yes, when it comes to M4, this kind of specific, you need plans, yes. At least a three is not what I said. I didn't say that. But you will need to have a plan. Okay. Don't bite me. Are you really 3Q? I'm sorry. Because you always have very nice ideas. Okay. To me, you are potentially better than that. Seriously, you are potentially better than that. I'm not saying that's a good timing. I'm saying that's a good instinct. Okay, doesn't matter. So I think why, yeah, black doesn't really plan by attacking here, right? So I'm saying those two stones, we don't really have a good method to attack. So we shouldn't continue playing there. And the Niels earlier, I'm sorry, you will have a good plan or what? I'm sorry. Do you have any good plan on attachment and the following? Okay, I get it. I'm sorry. Yeah. So here, okay, then I will continue. I'm sorry. Yeah, I misunderstood it. All right. So basically here, we don't have any good plan on attacking, so we're gonna leave it. And earlier, Niels has mentioned that gating is a big user. I'm sorry, however, it's a user move. Okay, here, okay, earlier I have mentioned about this structure at the bottom. Eden is something, let's say, worth for you to think more, in fact. Yeah, because that area is actually the biggest or the most empty area on the board, and we can't possibly just admit, okay, this is all white territory. That is actually another reason I'm saying this is a really good instinct. But this won't be my move because to me, that L3 is not ambitious enough. To me, the move should be attachment. But once again, yeah, this is probably too complicated. This is something I see. But okay, in general, so red side thing is done after the extension jump, and then when we turn to another part of the board, we play the biggest move. Oh, okay. Okay, you want me to go a bit further? Then actually, Kendall, I need you to actually tell me if this happens, what do you worry about white move next? K3 and L3. Ah, okay. Ah. Attachment and M4, really? The black is already alive, right? Black just push up, honey, honey here. Tiger, Atari, connect here. It's too easy. Here, I'm actually showing about a black counterattack. Black just want to live, just do this and make eye. Too easy. Forget it. White wouldn't do this. Earlier, I have said this is really good instinct. Actually, it works right away. I don't like it. It's mainly because like this. White basically keeps the majority of his territory. Black is as if just to play the user. So to me, this is a good instinct, but it didn't punish white enough. That is why I played deeper. But it's really good instinct. L3. I don't see many 2-3 kill player have this kind of instinct. Seriously, I don't. Most of this, let's say 2-3 kill player gonna tell me, I will just shoulder and reduce like this. So this is really good instinct. So this structure, if black just say, I want to get something out of it, too easy. And Niels earlier told something like, this one an attachment, I wouldn't say it's impossible. Possible. Because, white, this bottom structure is too problematic. Black's supposed to get something out of up here. Question is just which one is better than the other? But if you want to make this kind of thing work, you have to read it. But doesn't matter. So basically here, bottom is actually off topic already. As for the rest are attacking, after extend white jump, white at least for a while will be kept weak. He cannot directly, for example, next move, he play one move, he can directly live. Then our move, we can hardly see there's any move, we can actually for the benefit, so we leave it. And we just turn to elsewhere, that is the biggest on the board as our judgment. Yeah, I understand that. I don't think I can read all the variations myself. So let's say, for example, here, how did I choose J3? I have to say, let's say I chose that move by my instinct. Or in other words, I may say, I have experienced a similar situation before, and I chose that move by relying on my experience. And so, yeah, I can see, I still think L3 is pretty good. Okay, but that matter, we don't have. I just noticed our 2 hours is done. Okay, and okay, let's quickly go towards the next one. Yeah, at least I want to answer, let's say, all the given situations by force and by Kendall. Okay, I'm gonna answer all of that. So five. I try my best. Oh my God, I hate this kind of tree. Where is the end? Thanks. Okay. Yeah, so we are at this situation here, and white just play this move. Okay, so question is, how should we attack? Okay, I have to say, this is actually my impression with the given examples. I'm very surprised, how is it possible in that many games there's this kind of Ogemashimari against the Hoshi? In my games, I would say probably I play 100 games, I will see one. It's so rare. This kind of approach to Hoshi is so rare. Normally it's Kemashimari. It's Kema approach. Okay, doesn't matter. It doesn't really affect us. So how should we do this attacking? Feel it, please. Yeah. When you say you push him towards the wall, I hope you can imagine this term you are using in real life. Imagine you are fighting against the people and you say, I push him towards the wall. Note, you'd better push his body on the wall rather than there's a 2 meters distance. Then you are not putting him towards the wall. He's very comfortable. Yes. So here, this move is almost a must. Yeah, this move is actually the must. Yeah, you cannot let him get the top side, that extension. If you do like this, he gets the extension, how to attack? He gets a 2-space extension plus a comfortable distance with your wall. Yeah, this is what I mean earlier. You are saying I play at P17, so He's still 2 meters away from the wall. How can I say you are pushing him towards the wall? You need to make it done rather than I intend to push him towards the wall. However, that job can never be done. You did get the corner, but that's all the profit you can get because this group is considered safe. When you play on the top side, maybe you are saying like this, I get the top side, but it is actually some territory nearby to my wall. It's inefficient. There will be more. And I have another question to you here. Dare you say, what, you're going to take corner now by ignoring this N17? Attach, okay, attach is pretty good. I want to tell you, attach here, we have a to check out. Black just honey and connect, even the case that here, white basically give black the corner. Then black corner might be a smaller corner, but it is a solid corner, smaller, but plus, black get a plus at L17. Well, white is still not settled. And actually here, I didn't play the strongest. Black are also decent. Yeah, just think about this income. Earlier said, I play at P17, I get the corner. Are you saying when you play here, you were not gonna get the corner? Or the opponent will gonna take over the corner? Is that realistic? I understand you say, when I have to extend from my wall, it feels so wrong. I have to say, you play on P17, give him the two space extension, that is more wrong. Between the two wrong, pick one that is relatively better, please. I agree. Yeah, the feeling from here feels wrong. But what if the other one is more wrong? Okay, but yeah, if we start from here, can we see a flaw? Can you feel the flow? I guess, okay, we already come. I will take this one as the last example. And after that, I will just take questions, okay? Yeah, I believe questions might be more, let's say, useful to all the participants because it doesn't really limit to this topic. Okay, that's possible, but then why you approach outside at N17 as the first place? That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Okay, first, actually, black can peep here because this peep, white has almost no resistance. And also here, let's say we follow this floor. Does white want to make this exchange? It's actually a question because this gives white some eye shapes, but not enough for white to leave. And this gives black the majority of the corner already. So does white really want to do that? Or maybe white just want to get off and leave the center evasion as a possibility. So at least we have the opportunity in the future to take over the entire corner as white. Yeah, so this is, I'm talking about this. Yeah, Niels, you're right. I know you're right. And yeah, this is the correct move. This is correct. Yes. Because black that area, we already admit black that area. So why not make black over concentrated? So this is actually correct. Yeah, this is better than simply jump. No, this is not. This is not, but Niels can see it, so. Yeah, this is actually the best. To him, to Niels, this is a flaw. To me, this is a flaw. But if you can't see it, then to you, this is not. Yes, but what if they didn't think about it? I mean, yeah, when you say standard, it is standard to you and me. I'm saying here, the majority of our students, they are Cubans. Thanks. I'm sorry, I have some problem. I lost the KTS connection. I'm sorry. Okay, I come back now. I don't know what is going on over there. Sorry. Okay, so here, yeah, we are still here. Can everyone hear me again? Can everyone hear me? Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I have no idea what is going on. Yeah, got kicked out somehow. Okay, so yeah, but okay, so did, but here, this is clearly better. Let's take this one as a flow then. Okay, and then what we're gonna happen next? Let's just play natural move. So for example, watch up here. This is pretty natural, right? Yeah, I'm playing the move that everyone can understand. And now, okay, I guess to black, this is considered as eye shape, but then if white, for example, come over here, this doesn't look nice. So I think we probably should naturally come over around here. Okay, so yeah, this is basically the flow. And I would call this as basically attacking here. It's already. Why? Because I can see white Tanuki next. White's top side group is strong enough. He has a tiger. He can actually get some eye shape from here. He can get some eye shape from here. He can jump out. So white, yeah, white group is already strong enough. So I guess white here with Tanuki. White the two space jump here. Yeah, you are saying about the comparison with one space. My instinct told me it is two space. Yeah, if you want me to explain, I need to think. Yeah, so basically here, if white want to evade sun, then that will gonna be enormously weaker. R14, okay. So here you definitely want to play. Oh, white is not completely settled yet. You keep the pressure on. At least more or less pressure, you know, here, maybe you say this one more pressure doesn't do much, but it is accumulated. Yeah, so here definitely, yeah, it is high. About one space or two space, I only know that my instinct tell me it is two space, and what Niels has explained, yeah, is in general what I'm thinking about in my mind, but yeah, let's say one space or two space, here the difference is limited. I would say one space is possible. Yeah, because here, I mean, you play, okay, here, this is a feature. You play on the right side like this. Yeah, there's in general no pressure to the group. And the right side is, yeah, let's say doesn't really value too much anyway. Here, when you play the jump, the deficit is this one. So white has this move. But you can see right side, there's not much value anyway. So white, even if white get this move, so what? Yeah, you can see on the red side, white has this kind of here, so red side can hardly be developed. So white get that one as benefit, let it be then. That can be a good conclusion from, I'm sorry, it's difficult for me to pronounce. I'd rather just say, atomic, yeah. In general, that is right. And if you ask me to conclude, I would say, in the middle game, please remember, in the middle game, yeah. Normally, I speak in a simple way. Let me say, group goes first. Group first, point second. But if in a more, yeah, let's say in a way that goal theory tells us. Normally, in the middle game, we emphasize more on minus value. So group is minus value, cutting point is minus value, weak shape in the center is minus value. Those we put more emphasis on that because yeah, this is actually the balance of goal. In the early game, it's neither. In the middle game, we put more emphasis on minus value. In the end game, we only talk about plus value. This is the balance. Yeah, so if you say there is a small difference on, let's say I have two choices. One, I give slightly more pressure to the group or starting point. The other one, I get slightly more points. Which one I should take? If the circumstances is nothing special, I recommend you to put more pressure on groups or the cutting point. So emphasize more on minus value. I hope that's clear. That's the rule in the middle game in general. Yeah, and to us, let's say, we normally say European and American players, yeah, why our best players cannot even compete with any of Asian top players? Why? Basically, this question is answered. We emphasize too much on points or plus value. What is the basis for that method? I don't understand that question, I'm sorry. Actually, here, I believe about this is clear. And if you don't mind, here, we already have a question and answer session because it's impossible for us to finish all the rest of the examples. I'm sorry, yeah, earlier I have told Kendall, in my lecture, I always over-prepare. I probably actually prepared a double amount of examples. The groups value more in the middle game. I'm sorry, let me answer one by one. So the flow at this point would be try to run to each other. Ah, good question. Yes, that can be good. If your plan can be like this, yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm answering foods first. Because yeah, Kendall's question is slightly harder to answer. I need to take a bit time. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna answer Kendall's question. Kendall's question is a good group value more than the card weakness exactly. What is the basis? Ah, the goal theory. Okay. Goal theory is basically okay, goal theory tells this, but if I just say let's tell you the goal theory here, you may notice it's impossible for you to implement. Goal theory tells you that between plus value and minus value, there is a sensitive balance. Does it do anything to you? Between plus value and minus value, there's a balance. It doesn't say anything, right? That's goal theory, but that is not practical. That is not useful. So I made it in a more practical way. I'm saying, in general, in the middle game, you put more emphasis on minus value. Because that is a phenomenon to most of the goal players, what we do wrong. I translated the goal theory into a more practical way. remember, group is only here. When I say groups goes first, group is only the representative I have selected from minus value. In general, it should be minus value goes first. So group is treated equally to cutting point, limited liberty shape, and weak shape in the center. Yeah, they are all minus value. And those things should be considered first. Over points, but remember, goal theory also told us there's a sensitive balance. So, for example, we say there is a cutting point we should consider. On the other hand, there's 20 points. 20 points is pretty big. And Jeff has told me I should take the minus value goes first. Yeah, minus value goes first. So I ignore the 20 points. No, then you went too far. Yeah, there's a sensitive balance. Nils, I don't like it. I'm sorry. Yeah, your way to conclude. Yeah, in the end, goal is always about who gets more points. That's correct. But if you review pro games, you will notice the phenomenon. The phenomenon is in the middle game, the pro players rarely care too much about points. Even if they take points,
the intention is not to take points itself, but to give the opponent pressure. Yeah, so normally, yeah, let's say, yeah, in the middle game, you're gonna put your emphasis on minus value. Yeah, that is actually the phenomenon in pro games. And the Europeans, the European and American, we are not so good. Well, we are not good enough compared to Asian pros because we put too much emphasis on points all the time. Yeah. In the middle game. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm temporarily not answering because I want to finish this question with Kendall first. And about other questions, I will read it later, but I will finish this one first. So yes, in general, in the middle game, let's say that one, minus value should be more emphasized, but not absolutely. And for example, we have something just purely points, but it is really big. Then we can't ignore it. So it is not like less. Yeah, you would just do it without thinking. That's my theory that there is a sensitive balance. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you cannot do anything without. You can't just say theory says told us like this, so we just do that without thinking. That's impossible. Yeah. And on this part, on this theory, especially because this is, as you can see, a relatively difficult topic because theory actually told us there's a sensitive balance. And so basically there's a balance and how you're gonna get this balance. Balance is actually the hardest topic in Go. Yeah, so you can't just say, I will just go for one thing all the time. Then it's not a balance. Yeah, I hope this is clear. All right. Okay, I'm gonna answer others, but can I list the simple steps the procedure on attacking a group? Okay, so basically, when you notice a group, let's say the opponent has a weak group. You already noticed the opponent has a weak group. All right, so first, the first step is actually to find out, let's say all the directions that you can potentially attack. Just the directions, not the exact moves. All right, and then feel the floor. Look into in each tree, each variation, the next few moves. List yourself the simple moves. And then basically it is like you see different scenario. You just see different scenario as a picture, not necessarily in detail. And then you compare. And then you compare. But don't forget, it's not like among them you're gonna pick the best attacking. It could be eventually you say, actually none of them is comparable to Tanuki. So please remember, there's one picture you shouldn't neglect, that is to Tanuki. And then among all of those pictures, you pick the one that you think is the best. And then after you pick that picture, okay, I should attack I should attack in this direction. Then you think into detail about which move. Just please remember, you do not directly jump to moves. Tanuki is a move. Yeah, Tanuki is actually a big scenario you have to consider. After you decide, all right, so here I'm not in this group anymore. I'm gonna Tanuki, and then once again you come to detail. Where I'm gonna Tanuki? Where is the biggest? Yeah, there's still this kind of detail. So this is the procedure. I hope that's clear. Okay, I will answer this question. If you get sickness from putting pressure on a group, for example, you will get a profit from it somehow later. That's not a question. Yeah. So basically, when we say minus value, what is minus value? Minus value is something. It is as if you owe somebody money. Yeah, it is as if you owe somebody money. Of course, Yeah, let's say if when you owe somebody money, in both real life and on the go board, and especially on the, it could end up as you just pay him nothing. Yeah, I owe you money, I'm not gonna pay you back. Then you are brilliant. That's possible. But if you just owe too much and it's gradually accumulated, finally, what you pay may not be money, it could be your life. That's same as it is in real life. Yeah, if you owe too money. Yeah, if you owe too much money. That's goal. That's the goal planet. That's reality. It's not like I want it to be that way. And we know that on goal planet, there is a major difference compared to, let's say, the world we are living at. There's no government. There's no policeman. So everybody just defend he himself. Yeah, in that kind of world, of course, you have to be very careful. I think this is the last example I'm gonna give because actually we run out of time. Actually, I have already entered the question and answer, and so I'm now waiting for your questions. Yeah, actually, I do have more examples. As you can see, there are actually more trees. I actually prepared about a double number of examples, but it's not possible for us to finish. No problem. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. Now do you want the control or something? I'm sorry, I told me I answered that question, I believe. Ah, okay. Ah, but I believe our lecture is recorded, and later probably you can get it from my record because I have already explained about this entire procedure. Yeah, okay. That's exaggerating. If you may watch it one more time, I would say that's good enough. Just one more time. Because the most important thing is not like you understand it. Yeah, let's say after you understand it and then you do the practicing, you will notice actually theory and reality, there is actually a distance. So the more important part is actually to do practice. So after this lecture, if you listen to it one more time, and so to make sure you completely understand it, that's good enough. Then the most important thing is to just repeat those steps, that procedure, and then to make it part of you. So in the future, when you play your own games, you don't need to think about, okay, so what Jeff has mentioned in that lecture, what is exactly the procedure? You just do it naturally as if you have never learned this because it's already in your blood. It has become part of you. That's actually the point. I hope that's clear. Kandao, I'm sorry, do you need, let's say, control? Because you said you want to show some kind of situation or something. Oh, you don't have an example, but what exactly is your question? Yeah, if you can explain, I can come up with an example you want to ask. Dao San San, old style or new meta? If that's a question, I don't know how to. Well, it's always something interesting to try. And the two double San San is not like something weird or something completely out of line. To me, that is something worth to try. I would say it's interesting. I remember back to something like 5 to 6 years ago, when I was playing tournament here in Europe together with auntie, we have tried so many Sansan Fusaki and we love it at that time. Now we don't love it anymore. It's mainly because we both understand the value of center. So let's say stones in the center. So Sansan is a little bit too low. So we don't enjoy it anymore at least. But yeah, at that time we were both very territorial, so we have enjoyed Sun Fuzhang for quite a while. Okay. How to think about light shapes and the sacrifice in the marked shapes with light shape? I intend to just end up heavy when I'm trying to be light, or I save stones that I should have let go of. I'm sorry, I will give Fuz, he has specific question about Kandao's. I have to say, yeah, because your question is not it's not easy to answer. Yeah, without that example, it's difficult to answer. Kandao, I can answer you like this. Okay, Fuz, you can show yours example. Type your question, but I'm here gonna answer Kandao in general first. All right, yeah, Kandao, when you talk about light, please understand what does light mean. Light means some stones can die, or maybe even every single stone can die, but once it doesn't end up as everybody can die, or everybody dies, if you understand me. That is the meaning of light. And when you say, I really want to save my groups, I don't want anything to die, when you think about that way, you will definitely end up as being heavy. So this actually, I mean, when you are trying to play light, I mean, it is like, okay, you have to imagine like this. So I just want me, well, yeah, I'm, for example, I'm actually now inside the, let's say, I'm surrounded by so many enemies. And my intention here is just if I can survive to get out, then I'm good. So, let's say when I'm on the way to sacrifice, I can sacrifice my hand. I can probably sacrifice a shoulder. I can probably sacrifice a leg. Those things can be gone once finally I myself escapes. And in Go, the difficult part is sometimes you don't even know who is yourself. It actually can be I myself is dead, but my leg escapes. Then it is still a success. For example, but you need to have this kind of spirit on. Well, so surrounding the circumstances is really difficult, so something can die. And actually, it should be anything can die. Yeah, if it can be like that, then you have to play something light. It's actually, finally, it end up as heavy shape is mainly on how you think. It end up as heavy shape, normally it is you think as nothing can die. I'm sorry, let me see. Pincering 3-4. So I was wondering how should I have a plate here to build the red side. I'm sorry, so you are black. Are you saying, let's say, how you're gonna play as And when you play this pincer, you want to build the red side, yes. Well, in general, please remember, Joseki is surface unless when it comes to reading. Otherwise, Joseki is surface. Essentially, it's about direction. So here, when you play the two-space high pincer, your emphasis is not on the red side. Your emphasis is on attacking white, this approaching stone. That is basically your starting point on play the two-space high pincer. And so you cannot complain on, I play the two-space high pincer, it doesn't work well with my red side, because that wasn't your intention. In general, I will talk about this in theory. I'm sorry, just one moment. Yeah, in general, I will talk about this in theory first. High pincer, whenever you play high pincer, so fourth line pincer, you are basically emphasizing on attacking. So you play the high. Low pincer, you actually have a different plans here. Let's say when you play low pincer, you don't really care about to attack him. Because low pincer, you can hardly restrict the opponent. when he escapes. Yeah, so for example, here you play the high pincer, your emphasis is on this corner. So you have to, yeah, you have to continue here. So yeah, in this corner, in the game, here this is a Joseki, and this is an old Joseki. Yeah, nowadays people play Kosumi to attack. Yeah, you can see here, black, you can see. I mean, even after black played this one, those two stones, the distance with this one is very far away. So can you say black play this pincer is to work with the Shimari? Impossible. Yeah, the distance is that far, but it works pretty well on attacking white those stones, because now black white those stones doesn't have enough eye shape. This is doing attacking. Well, we always know that if you just consider about the extension, the distance, yeah, around Hoshi is the right one. But then it has nothing to do with that approaching stone itself, right? Yeah, this is not a pincer. When you say I'm doing a pincer, in general, you are saying I am attacking that stone. And then I'm saying, for example, we say this is a relatively acceptable distance as for the extension from the Shimari, if not perfect. Yeah, if you are considering that is fine. Then you do not ask about how severe you want to attack with that approaching stone. Yeah, you take care of one thing, you just cannot take the other thing. There's nothing perfect. Yeah, so this is basically how we understand. This helps, let's say, this more or less take care of the, let's say, the distance from the Shimari as extension, not perfect. This one more or less attacks the approaching stone, but with a three-space pincer, not perfect. So it is kind of like, yeah, let's say, it is a compromise. And most people we're gonna do as, I'm gonna get a perfect extension. Forget about the pincer, or I'm just gonna attack it, and then I'll forget about the extension. I personally suggest you just do it this way. Concentrate on one thing. Do not think about I want to get this and that. Even pro players rarely do that. Depends. You can consider about when pincer you want to attack. You can also consider, let's say, not to attack. It's your choice. You don't know many Joseki? Well, in most of the situation, when you do pincer, let's say it comes to, for example, here, let's say, not know Joseki, okay? So he jumped here, I just jumped here, okay? Then he just counter pincer me, I jump. In most of the pincer, it will come to situations similar to this. Then you don't need to know many Joseki. Yeah, that's natural for pincer. The opponent may not do it. Yeah, if he attack here, okay, so he's seeking for a base, I cannot let him get a base, yeah? So like this, I'm gonna keep attacking. I do not like him get a base. Yeah, you don't need to know many Joseki. Here you can do things in general, right? And I can only say in general, right? You can see this position is not as good as jump, but it doesn't affect you much. I hope this is clear. Yes, you can always tanuki. If you do not do anything. But just remember, in general, you play the direction. Yeah, you also, I mean, here, pincer is an option. You don't have to pincer. This area, when I play against my student, I usually play the diagonal move. Yeah, I play this move is mainly,
Yeah, recently also I watched too much Hikaru. Counter pins or try to set it in the corner. If you get pin set, what do you want? It's not about here. What is the best answer? For example, here, this way, if you ask me, Jeff, how you gonna play as white? In my games, I always just, yeah, I kind of tanuki. Yeah, because to me, yeah, this corner may not be that important. Yeah, this is my way. Yeah, and if you say right side is more important, then your counter pins. If you think corner is more important, you kick at the honey. Yeah, here, you know, let's say this kind of early game choices is like, I mean, you can actually freely choose what you want in general, and unless your opponent fight against you, but normally you can freely choose. Do you understand me? Yeah, there's nothing. Yeah, there's no such thing as this must be good, the other one must be bad. It's similar as you just enter university. Yeah, this cross looks interesting. That cross is fun. This cross might have a bright future. Yeah, we don't know. So it's your choice. Yeah, there's not anything certain. That is good. But after you selected some, you have learned some crosses and then you need to pass them. And after you pass the exam, you're facing to graduation and get a job. Only at that moment, there will be some choices that will be specific good and some choices, obviously, that will be bad. Yeah, only at that moment. But before that, yeah, here, yeah, choosing your major, your crosses, you can just freely choose, similar to that. Okay, you don't know Jiu-Jitsu. Yeah, if you say, I don't know many Jiu-Jitsu. Yeah, then try to play elsewhere. He kick, I play elsewhere once again. He honey here, I once again play elsewhere. I don't need to know any Jiu-Jitsu. I can tell you, actually, I don't need to do this because actually, in my mind, I have already memorized in general, the entire Ishida Jiu-Jitsu dictionary, almost all the variations, because when I was in college, I read that book too much, so I basically memorized almost all the variations and the conclusions. I don't need to do this, but to me, to play Jiu-Jitsu is boring. So it's just one corner directly, 20, 30 moves are gone, and the people just play that by relying on memory. That's not fun. Yeah, I prefer to directly from the start. We just play go. Right, then just play like this. Yeah. Yeah, to play by memory is pretty boring. I agree. No, don't. Yeah, so here you say, he pins on me. I don't know what to do. Tanuki. And I play here is basically to push black to continue. Because if he doesn't continue, I have an extra stone there at K17. On the top right corner, when I choose my move, black, you're gonna have a limited choice left. So here, when I play here, I push black to choose. Yeah, the here, but it's not my business. Okay, what is Joseki? Joseki is just two things in general, but not easy. Joseki is logic plus reading. Mostly it is, okay, I can say logic, or I can also say the. Yeah, so which direction is more important? Is the top side, is the right side, or the corner? Yeah, first, yeah, you choose what direction is more important. Then you decide your direction, and then you're gonna choose the specific move. And when it comes to specific move, when it comes to, for example, stones clash to each other, then it's inevitable you have to read it. So yeah, there's also reading. Ah, no problem. Yeah, thank you, Fuss. You have also asked, let us supply most of the examples. I appreciate. Okay, yeah, and for the rest of us, 10 minutes or so before we finish, and you can still ask for more questions, please. Okay, I'm looking forward for your actively participation next time still, and I hope you may supply more questions, yeah, in the future still. Thank you. I'm sorry, Nils, I don't answer that kind of question. That kind of question I will answer you when we meet in real life, and if I know the player, well, the player you asked, I know, but not very familiar with. I'm not very familiar with. Yeah, but still, yeah, here we are in the online session. I don't because that kind of question is not very useful to most of the participants. Well, that's also a question actually I don't want to answer, but okay. I'm teaching chess in school. I'm teaching Go in school, and I'm also teaching chess in school. Tomorrow I'm gonna teach Go in school, and on Tuesday I'm gonna teach chess. Yeah, so I can play chess. I can play chess, and I think I'm not too bad, but it's not because I'm good at chess. It's mainly because I think my Go is stronger, and Go is mainly a game about reading. I mean, Go is a game, refers to a lot about reading, and chess is a game mainly about reading. So I don't know any chess fuseki, or I don't know much about it, but I just rely on my reading to compensate. Okay. Ah, Brandon, your question is very good. That is also very difficult to answer because there is a line in between overconcentrated or being solid. There is a line, but that line is not visible. There is a line there. So you have to feel it. I'm sorry, I'm not sure if I can answer more than that. That is a very good question to answer. Is there a way? Brandon, the best way I can tell you, the more you play, the more you get. Yeah, just play more games. And if possible, after the game, show that to a stronger player. The stronger player will gonna tell you if it is solid or it is overconcentrated. Gradually, there's only one way to get this. So gradually you'll get more experience, and then you'll feel what is solid, what is overconcentrated. Yeah, you can feel it. To me, this is the only way. Because yeah, between them, there is a line, but it's yeah, you can't see it, so you can only feel it. All right, okay, I will take another question. What is that? Let me see. I'm sorry, I can't see other questions yet. I only have questions. If you have any questions, could you just copy paste? Yeah, please. You want control or something else? The Shimari situation in the bottom right. Okay, yeah, I will give a control. Yeah, that's easier. There are a lot of examples. I'm not sure which one. You'd better just find an empty board and show it yourself. Yeah. If you can remember, I'm saying you can just show it on an empty. Oh, this one, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Okay, so what is, oh, yeah, what I believe there, and you get the outside influence.
My guess is that's what you want, right? I can directly tell you what is online, because my next movie is Q3. You will, yes. If I recall that game situation, I'm sorry, Niels, we have to go into detail, okay? Let's just show the variation. So white play Q3, we have to go to detail. Red side is kind of empty in my mind that the black has a stone at Q14, that's it. Yeah, black has a stone at Q14 and Q16, so that kind of shape. Yeah, so you're gonna connect. Yeah, you're gonna connect here, yes. You turn in the corner and he push at M3. Yeah, and probably turn first, turn at N4. Yeah, your honey, and he came on K2. Yeah, that's very likely the case. Okay, yeah, so like this, right side is very broad, and so you are in general happy about this. I understand this logic, but Niels, I need to tell this, and it looked like your goal didn't really change much over years. I feel like this is still the Niels I have talked with back to how many years ago? I don't remember anymore. I'm sorry. I hope you consider at the bottom here, white leaves pretty big, and I hope you take bottom as black investment. So even though you get some very happy result on the red side, you paid for it. Yeah, it is just like you get a very good meal. See that here? So yeah, there's some some grilled chicken, and there's some that's some very good food. I'm not very good at food. Yeah, you get a very good food and a huge amount. You like it? No, you paid €20 for it. Yeah, so you do not only appreciate the good food. Please also consider the value, how much you have paid. White like this lived at the bottom rather comfortably. And never forget, initially he has only one stone at N3, one stone to evade. He wasn't alive, only one stone. Now he lives by taking so many points himself. I'm sorry, I'm talking about food. Because he, I mean, black is basically saying, on the red side, he got a really good structure. I described that as a pretty good dish of food. And I'm saying you also paid a big amount of money. So is it really worth it? That is how it turned to grilled chicken. Yeah. Okay, I don't remember. I have mentioned now about fried chicken. Okay. to me, I'm not. Yeah, I don't mind. Yeah, it's approaching to sleeping time, but doesn't matter. I will take one last question, maybe. Ah, really? Okay. Aggressive, passive, neither of them is good. Yeah, you'd better accept something normal. Okay, I will take one more question, please. Anyway, one more question. How to judge inefficiency inefficiency? I don't understand. How to judge inefficiency versus I understand the question. I remember in the American, you know, the presidential election, there were in total four candidates. Can you name the third and the fourth candidate? I think the third candidate, the surname is Johnson. The last one is like Stern. Something like that. Yeah, Johnson is the third. Yeah, Jill Stern is the, yeah, he's the She's the last. Doesn't matter. Who got more votes? I guess Jonathan got more votes, right? Yeah, Jonathan got more votes. So he is more efficient. They are both inefficient, but Jonathan is relatively more efficient. That's my answer. Yeah, I mean, I can only answer questions like this. So they are both inefficient. They actually also did a whole campaign. Yeah, the other two candidates, they also did a whole campaign, but they only get that limited votes. So they are both inefficient, but who is more efficient? The one who got more. So the one is less inefficient is the one that is relatively more efficient. That's I can only answer like that. Because let's say I don't completely understand the question still. Would I count number of moves? You'd better give me an example. Otherwise, this is too deep. Do you want control? I will answer about atomic first. 3-3, threatened by a double approach. Yes, because 3-3 itself is not enough, just by itself. So normally, if 3-3 is facing to especially a third line approach, you'd better answer. Yeah, of course, because the 3-3 means you only control a box in the corner. That is like a 4. That is not enough to live by itself. No, it's not. No. Yeah, you definitely need. That is solid to get points under the premise if it lives. Okay, I will read what Kandao said one moment. 10 moves to take territory versus 6 to take the same amount. Ah. Yeah, Kandao, I personally suggest that you might actually bring examples because this example, just this abstract, is difficult to answer. You can actually bring examples from any game. Yeah, pro game, your own game, yeah, hide-and game, it doesn't matter. But we need examples. We can't just talk like this about efficiency. Yeah. Okay, good. Yeah, okay. Yeah, in that case, I suggest we may just finish here today. All right? Yeah, okay, good. Yeah, okay, so thanks for your concentration and active participation. And I hope to talk to you again, let's say, that will be next time, it will be on January. And I hope to see you all again, okay? No problem. Okay, so talk to you later then. See you. Good night.